I'm not going to be able to do that. Diseases, you know, cancer, AIDS, a whole number of different things. And so Jesus is still always in the business of saving souls, but he's still healing people. Hallelujah. Jesus is real, and he does want a relationship with you, with your Heavenly Father. Praise God. God bless. Jesus loves us. Jesus loves you very much. Don't forget that. I'd meet a murderer there. I'd meet someone who actually killed somebody. And so I went down, and I worked in this Christian cafe for a little while, and I chatted to this guy. I said, the Lord sent me down here because he told me that somebody here has murdered someone. And the guy looked at me as if he'd seen a ghost. Never mind going to these ghostly tours. The guy's face was like a sheep. And the next week he took me in to see the manager. He says, tell the manager exactly what you told me last week, and I told him. And what actually happened was that guy was waiting trial. He was actually waiting trial because he was in a fight somewhere in Glasgow. But he told God, he said, if you can forgive me of this sin, I will follow you. I will devote my life to you. So what actually happened? He was waiting on a decision. He'd already been to court and all that stuff. He was praying about it. And he gave his testimony that night. He actually confessed before God and men the sin that he did. And what actually happened was he was forgiven. God actually forgave him. He didn't go to jail.
You get drunk, you get mad, mate.
and to this very day still following Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. So it shows you, no matter what sin you've actually done, you can still be received into the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. You don't need to walk in darkness. You don't need to live with your sin and guilt. You know, you don't need to go around with hatred in your heart towards people, towards different things, towards God even. Hallelujah. Jesus said a man must be born again to inherit God's kingdom. That's what Jesus said. I didn't say it. Jesus said that. He didn't say become religious. He didn't say, I'll give you this brand new religion, you can just follow it. He said, come and follow me. I am the way, the truth, the life. That's what Jesus said. A man must be born again. How do we get born again? Does it mean we have to enter into our mother's womb again and literally be born again? Not at all. It's a spiritual birth from above. The kingdom of heaven is a spiritually discerned kingdom. And the Bible says that the children recognize that kingdom. Little children belong to the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. I've never met a child who said they don't believe in God. Every child that I've ever met, they say, I believe there's a God. I believe in God. But the real question is, who is Jesus Christ? Who is Jesus Christ? That's the question. That if you take him on his word, he's the only way into heaven. He's the propitiation for your sin. If you actually read about him in the Vedas, if you're a Hindu, talks about the Prajapati sacrifice. Only Jesus did that. There was no other major religious leader that died for the sins of his people. That was Jesus Christ that did that. If you check out the Quran, you're saying, well, Jesus didn't really die, just someone standing in and he was actually taken up to heaven. You know in the Quran that he's the judge of the earth. But do you know that there's actually lines in that Quran, in the Surah 3, Surah 19, that talk about Jesus' death and resurrection from God's own lips, from God's own mouth, and from Jesus' own mouth. And so what you have to deduce from that, you have to say, well, if Jesus was a prophet and he was prophesying of his death and resurrection in Surah 19:33, and we believe Jesus is a prophet, wouldn't you actually trust that Jesus did what he said was going to happen? He died for the sins of his people, according to the Torah, according to many other religions that require a blood sacrifice. Jesus fulfilled that. That final sacrifice that God accepted, that was what Jesus did. Hallelujah. And he's the only way into heaven. If you take him on his word, if you take Jesus Christ on his word, you will go to heaven. If you count him a liar, try and do it your way. You know, try and get into heaven through good works. Try and get into heaven through being religious. It's not going to work, but try it if you want. Many people have tried different religions, Buddhism, Hinduism, all the isms, but then they come to Jesus. Jesus is the way, the truth, the life. And when we accept him, he actually fills us with his Holy Spirit. Jesus said, blessed are they who mourn, they shall be comforted. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst after righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Do you hunger and thirst after righteousness? You know, 400 years ago, this nation demanded that we get the scriptures, we get the King James Bible, so that the people can read it for themselves, even though the Catholic Church burned people alive who actually possessed Bibles, and burned their families if you possessed the Bible. It wasn't very Christian, is it? But all these people wanted was to read the Word of God for themselves, and we still have that privilege. We still have that privilege. But for how long? How long do you want that privilege? How long? It's always available. As long as Jesus hasn't returned in the clouds, you can still repent. You can still be born again through confessing that you're a sinner and asking him into your life. Hallelujah. That's all we need to do. Very, very simple. Jesus did it for us all on the cross at Calvary. He did it for us all. All we need to do is believe. Believe and receive. Praise the Lord. Thank you.
Thank you. What's outside your house? A big cathedral.
Interesting.
Sorry, Jimmy, man. Are you interested in music as well?
Ah, nah. I'm a retired preacher.
Okay.
Thank you.
okay.